So hi, I'm Christina, and we are currently behind the scenes. We're actually just underneath of the Shark and Ray touch tank right now. So here in the West Wing at New England Aquarium, we display a number of different animals, and one of those are our Cassiopeia upside down jellies. The exhibit itself looks like it's really brightly lit to our eyes, but for the jellies, it actually doesn't have enough sun to do photosynthesis. So because of that, we actually need to take those jellies off of exhibit and put them in what I like to call the sun sauna, which is just a holding tank that has super bright lights. And those lights will help support the photosynthetic process and allow the jellies to feed off of this photosynthetic energy like they naturally would in the wild. One of the challenges of that is actually tracking who is in which position. So we actually have three different groups of jellies. And at any one time, one group will be upstairs on exhibit, and the other two groups will actually be downstairs where we are right now behind the scenes. So when they're behind the scenes, we need to be able to make sure that we can tell them apart, and that's where the tagging comes in. So by providing these tags for the jellies, we can actually tell who is in each group, how long they've been upstairs in this shady, stormy, kind of low light situation, and how long they've been downstairs in the sun sauna in their kind of full sun, summer afternoon kind of situation. So what we did today was called elastomer tagging. So the elastomer is a little piece of biosafe plastic that we're injecting into the tissue of the jellies. And in order to make it injectable, it's actually a two-part mixture, and they continue to be a liquid for a little bit until they actually solidify once they're in the tissue of the jelly. And that tag is actually fluorescent. So you can actually see us using the blue light in order to make that tag glow. And that's how we can tell them apart. We're placing the tags in the umbrella. Some people also call it the bell of the jelly. So that smooth surface area of the jelly. And you won't see those on exhibit because these jellies in particular, instead of swimming around like your typical Medusa with their bell up on the top and their arms hanging down, they actually sit upside down, like their name suggests, upside down jellyfish, and rest that bell on the bottom of the exhibit. So another reason that these tags are really helpful for us is because we can track the welfare of the group as a whole. Some of the things that we're looking at for welfare are things like physical condition. So do these animals look like they are healthy? Or are their bells a little bit tattered? Does it look like maybe there have been some injuries, things like that? Are they growing? So that's a really good indicator for us that they're getting the nutrition that they need and that they're being exposed to an environment that is supporting them, both temperature and flow. These are things that are really important for jellies. In order to determine whether or not they're growing, we actually measure them. We measure in centimeters by putting a little ruler underneath the jelly. And as the jelly pulses open, we'll take that measurement and record it. Because we're actually tracking groups of jellies instead of individuals, we're going to average that number out and track the growth of the group as a whole over time. This is one element of a holistic welfare lens that we look at with our animals. We want to make sure that when they're young, they're growing, when they're adults, they're stable and thriving, and that when they're older, we care for them throughout their entire life from beginning to end. That's our responsibility as animal care stewards, and it's something that we've spend a lot of time and passion and energy in doing here at New England Aquarium. Thanks for visiting me here in the West Wing and learning a little bit more about our Cassiopeia jellyfish and how we care for all of our animals, from the largest vertebrates to the smallest invertebrates. Be sure to come visit these guys on exhibit in the West Wing at New England Aquarium.